Janet Kataha Museveni is non-committal on just when schools will be reopened across the country, especially after the lockdown that was conditioned by the COVID-19 pandemic. While speaking during the release of 2020 PLE results today, Janet Museveni said government is in no rush to expose the millions of learners to COVID-19. She also said that the cases of malpractice are increasing, and she called for tougher punishments for those that are found to be practicing some of the vices.
It is a day to thank God, who has been faithful, really faithful, as he carried these young people and all of us as the education sector and our whole nation through a very unusual season that we have been going through.
While releasing the 2020 primary leaving examination results at the State House in Entebbe, the Minister of Education and Sports, Janet Kataha Museveni, said she is not certain on when schools will be reopened after the COVID-19 induced lockdown. She noted that government will not rush to return learners to school when the coronavirus is still ravaging the country.
These decisions are made by government after they have been discussed at cabinet level, and government is contented that this is the right time for schools to open, or when they are to close, when schools should close. And when that has not been done, it's premature for anybody to say we will open at this time. So I don't want to say that we have a time in future that we know that we will open.
She, however, revealed that they are contemplating reopening schools for medical students.
I know that the medical students are in need to go back to their institutions of learning. But I want you to know that we're discussing your request. We are looking at everything, and we'll come back to you as soon as possible. But I can't say now.
Commenting on the 2020 PLE results, Mrs. Museveni applauded digital learning interventions and study materials which government distributed for home learning. She said they contributed greatly to the performance of the pupils.
We do appreciate the role digital learning platforms play in delivery of formal education during school closures. It has worked in a handful of urban international and private schools here, and been utilized widely in developed countries. However, given other equally important priorities of the state, it is not within our means to deliver internet to all the 15,423 primary schools.
She, however, cautioned schools and pupils against holding gatherings to celebrate the results, fear of COVID-19 spread being the main factor.
This excitement must be managed well, and there should be no celebrations that will bring groups of people together to risk the lives of others. This must be a responsibility of those families again.
Mrs. Museveni encouraged students at home due to the lockdown not to give up but remain focused on their education.
To our young people and adults out there, make a stand and choose not to give up on your goals. Because of the inconveniences you are feeling now, you are meeting now, either because of closure of schools or disruption of livelihood or even the grief of losing the loved ones. However, when we lose the hope that we can reach our goals, not only do we despair, but we also fail to prepare for life that will be after the bad situation is no more.
She expressed concerns over the number of students who register for PLE and not turn up for exams. She called on parents and guardians to play a better role in guiding their children.
This is where we need the help from the parents, because we must track these children who register because they want to do exams but never get to do them. I pray we'll provide now the breakdown of these absentee candidates to each local government and let the education officers follow up to establish what happened to these learners.
The minister also condemned examination malpractices and called for tougher punishments for perpetrators.
Some of our education stakeholders, including teachers, are still not heeding our call to desist from the evil practice of cheating in examinations. I have also noted that some schools and districts are perennially known for cheating examinations for their candidates year after year. This type of corruption must be put to an end.
Those that have passed PLE will wait to hear from the Ministry of Education on when the selection exercise for secondary school will be conducted. This story was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news in Entebbe.